Before we start the video, I want to let you know that you and your friend have a chance to win King Life t-shirt. I will explain how in a bit. The brand itself, King Life, is a lifestyle brand and it's not about being rich or showing the richer people lifestyle. It's about being king of your life no matter what your circumstance. It's about you living your life, developing and reaching your goals and being happy. So how to take part in a giveaway? Go to my Instagram, find the giveaway post, tag your friend under this picture and you're good to go. You can tag as many friends as you want. In order to win, you have to be a follower on my Instagram and on my YouTube channel. At the end of the September, I will choose a winner. I hope that's clear for everyone. Now let's get back to the video. Got so far, thank you and welcome. I encourage you to subscribe, that will help me a lot. In this video, we will go for a ride in the forest, then on the sand, and since I'm so excited about hard enduro and I'm getting a little bit better at it, I will show you how we made the little enduro track in my friend's backyard. So let's go for a ride. And two of my friends decided to go for a chill ride in the forest with a twist. My friend wanted to have a little bit more of enduro riding, so we decided to took him on our standard beginner track. Little ditch, little logs and forest roads, roads and roads. But this time we decided to ride on a beach type of sand as well. If you have tried it, you know that your bike will go wobbly all over the place if you don't hold it with your legs. So let's drive to the sands. Open up your identity. Don't give up so easily. At the sand trail. This is my friend's first time riding on sand. We arrived at the ditch. I took a lead and drove over the ditch. Ren is followed as well. John was holding back because for the first timer doing it, it might seem scary. Because I use super view on camera, you don't see it as deep and wide as it actually is. So before he started to ride, he threw across. Sadly, not enough throttle in the end and the bike started to slip back and of course he had to drop the bike. Actually, I made the same mistake first time riding at this place. Yeah, that's a big fail. Second time we drove over it and he passed it with no problem. But this is the part where I get a little bit angry at my friend. Not John, but the other dude. I'll explain in a moment. Yeah. drove up to my friend and asked if the camera was rolling because I didn't recall turning it on. I asked and he replied, nope. So I clicked the record button and then... Yep, all the way home and a lot of fun footage was not recorded. Before we started to build enduro obstacles, I tried to do a little wall ride, just exploring how bike would act on a steep wall. Did not drive over because on the other side was a super steep and deep pit. In order to get over, I needed to catapult myself over, and I'm not just yet in that skill group to pull that off. So after this trip, me and Rain started to build our track. We went in the forest and found some tree that had already fallen and started to chainsaw it. We decided to make a couple basic elements. First element was tree logs. After them, we raised bar and made higher element of 3 logs, so we can train ourselves to ride consistently over the logs using clutch, brakes and throttle correctly. To make it even harder, we add tires as fourth element. We dug ground under them and placed two big tires next to each other. We knew that if we would ride over them as they are right now, they will split. I came up with a smart solution of tightening them up with the rope. In the end, we add two more smaller tires just to have more surface to cross. How we tested the track, we're gonna show you in the next video, because for this filming period, not me or Rain had the bike ready. Thanks for watching, see you on the next video.